originally lavender. Well, we can't have a pretty lavender nightgown at Briarcliff, so we'd work together on what color, like a muddy plum or a putty-colored beige. But we want to make sure that it doesn't blend into the walls, because that's what they're going to be wearing all the time. So obviously, we don't want to put them in green shirts and all the walls are green. It would just not be very interesting to look at. So we work, Mark and I work very closely together on the color palettes.
Well, 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 well. Isn't this pleasant, the three of us sitting around like civilized people?
When I first started looking for the furniture for the common room, we originally started looking a little bit more 50s. Ryan said, oh, no, that isn't really where I want to go with it. So we went kind of 30s, 20s, Victorian, and dilapidated, and he's happy with it.
We have to talk.
The sets are very creepy and have actually done a great deal to inform, I think, a lot of performances. I mean, there's a sofa over there with, like, a bloodstain note on it from what happens in episode 5, and you're just, like, we're in here sometimes, and Jessica and Evan and I were like, oops, I had an accident in a chair, because it's just, like, this really disgusting chair. It's, like, just not right.